It's the Kirkby ski slope, already a legend in its own brief troubled lifetime. The ski slope which was built without planning permission, over a water main, on land the council didn't own. The ski slope that Nationwide first wondered at when my colleague James Hogg visited it on a skiing tour of the north. Surveying the dramatic sweep of the new slope towards the Fazakerley turnoff of the M57, James was the first to surmise, it's the wrong way round. Work originally began in November 1973. The ski slope was to be ready within 6 months. Now, 2 years later, it's never been skied on, and it never will be, because it's to be demolished, knocked down before it falls down. Since the cost of it has jumped from $90,000 to $140,000, the ratepayers of Kirkby must feel entitled to ask how it all started. And it started one lunchtime, in a pub just down the road. Dave Tempest, former leader of Kirkby Council, was there. So was the borough architect, Eric Stevenson. And so was his friend, George Leatherbarrow, the council's main contractor. You can visualise the scene. I want a ski slope, said Dave. You design it, Eric, and you can build it, George. So they did. There were no tenders, no quotations, no paperwork at all. Until a year later, when questions were asked. Then a piece of paper did appear. It was from George, confirming his price. £64,388. Cheers. The slope struggled up through delays and extra expenditure. They had to build an embankment to prevent the young skiers of Kirkby slaloming around the Fazakerley turnoff. They needed railings round the top of the mound to stop people falling off. But most of all, they needed to know about the bumps. The big bumps which kept bulging about the skiing surface. They spent £5,000 in vain attempts to debump it. We suggested last May what had possibly contributed to the bumps. Perhaps it had something to do with the material that the contractor, George Leatherbarrow, had built it with. George was being paid by the council to provide suitable material for the ski slope hill, so he could hardly go around charging other people to dump their own suitable rubbish there. No, no. George, who's characterised himself to our colleagues as a generous man, broadcast the good news instead in the Liverpool Echo. Free tip in Kirkby, he proclaimed. And they came in their hundreds, according to local lorry operator Alf Seddon. He dumped a couple of loads himself before he found his lorries wouldn't operate anymore up the steep sides of the rapidly growing mountain. So, what exactly is there inside the great white elephant? Mr. Stevenson told us that the suitable material he had specified was to be rock and rock sand pieces, and indeed, there is some. Up to about there, I should think. And what of the rest? Well, even a layman can recognise that here there's been a minor landslide, because the trees, which were once vertical, are now horizontal. The council's inquiries, however, into what had happened here were a little more scientific. After our film, the council called in an independent group of surveyors who made test borings on the ski slope. Their evidence was startling. To quote from the surveyor's report, there is sand and there are sandstone pieces in here, but there's also what can only be described as a haphazard collection of builder's rubble. Wood, brick, ashes, clay, old bits of can, paper, everything, including this very notorious material, slag heap shale. Notorious and very loose. The people of Kirkby really have been lumbered with a heap of old rubbish. Now, I'm wearing all this gear, the safety rope and so on, because I've read the rest of the surveyor's report, which says that there's already been some surface failure, and that means that bits and pieces have been falling off already. Bits like that colliery slag heap down there, and the large piece of masonry up here, which if this rain continues, could fall down any day now. But there's more than that too. The surveyors have done some pretty complicated mathematics, which suggests that nowhere on these slopes do they fully measure up to the accepted safety factors. The slopes are too steep, steeper for instance than you're allowed to build a motorway embankment, And they're also made of material which is too loose. And all that means, in their own words, is that the slopes are potentially unstable and liable to fail in some manner, or fall down. I think you better haul me up, lads. So, how has this fiasco been allowed to happen? Where's all the paperwork, all the cross-checks? Well, as we've told you, there isn't any. But there is one letter, dated March 1973, from a ski slope expert to the then manager of the sports centre, Dick Lane. In it, he describes the ski slope scheme as suicidal. Yes, it is the wrong way round. For most of the day, and it's late now, the sun would be right into the eyes of the skiers. He says it's too high, too fast, and too near the motorway. And one other thing that most of us wouldn't consider. The crosswinds which sweep in so dramatically across that motorway so often disappear just as dramatically halfway down, and so indeed could the skiers themselves. The sports centre manager, Dick Lane, has told us that he sent a copy of that letter to Mr. Stevenson, the architect. But no action was taken. The people of Kirkby might have been saved a £140,000 bill for an amenity they never asked for, never wanted. And there's a lot of things that they do want. The money could have paid for youth clubs or old folks' homes. As it is, they've got a ski slope no one ever has, nor ever will, ski down. He alone has had the benefit of one brief flurry that cost £140,000.
By Jove, I needed that!